morning, welcome to Craft Your Love. I'm Deepti and I'm starting a new series called Trash to Treasure with Deepti, where I will be reusing some waste materials or some old or broken items into something beautiful and useful. Today's video is part of that series, and today we will be converting sweet boxes into these beautiful frames that you see behind me. So we will be creating frames, hanging shelves and also a tray. So let's start with today's DIY and have fun. I am taking these two sweet boxes and let's start with this one. This box is strong enough to be used as a tray. Also, it comes with this plastic lining, so I am using it as it is. It is also well covered with silver paper, so I don't have to do much. But I am adding this designer paper to give some color. So let's cut it. I will place it here and then I am adding an OHP sheet on top of this. I am using this wooden butterfly and I am gluing it on both the sides. And there the tray is ready, made out of a sweet box. Next I am using this sweet box. This one is not that strong, so I will discard the cover of it and I will use only the inside part to create frames out of it, as it has a very nice border. So I will use that for creating frames. Start with the larger one first. I am using this designer paper which I have already cut and gluing it with the help of Fevicol very carefully in the center of this box. Here I am also writing a code, enjoy the little things. Here I forgot to write the code before pasting the paper. So in case you are trying this out, please make sure that you write the code first and then paste it inside the box. Otherwise it will be a little difficult to write. I am using these dried out branches to create a tree. So using a hot glue gun, I will stick it inside this box on this left side. And to create some flowers or to give some pop-up effect, I am using these thermocol balls, and using the hot glue gun, I am adding it at different places randomly on these branches. So until I am happy with the placement, I will keep on adding these randomly. And now using this cutout, I already had this cutout, so I am using this. I like to move the design here and there and see what looks better. So sometimes I cut, sometimes I just use it as it is. I just try to figure out what is looking good. So that's how I just keep on working on the design, and once I'm happy with the composition, I just use any medium of glue to stick it together. Here I'm using a glue gun to stick it, and I'm also using double-sided tape to give it some dimension. Also adding few more thermocol balls, and then I will cover it with the OHP sheet so that it creates a frame and none of the thermocol balls fall out. So it will give a nice glass effect. And then I am making a border using these stripes. These are the cutouts from the paper that I have used on the center. So same designer paper I am using to make the border. And that's it, the wall frame is ready. Let's move on to making the next frame. So for this one, I have to secure the edges. For that, I'm using double-sided tape and sticking the edges together. And whatever extra part is there, I will chop it off using scissor. I have cut the paper of its size and using Fevicol, I will glue it. Here I am am using a square cutout from a golden sheet, and I also had this love cutout. And to give it some height, I am using a cutout from a tissue roll. So this will give me some height. So firstly, I am gluing this love cutout on this square paper. I am using two different color of cutout so that it gives me a 3D effect. And now using glue gun, I will stick them all together. Also adding thermocol balls here to have a cohesive look in all the frames that I create. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm also sticking single thermocol pieces here and there randomly. Whenever you create something, try doing in different ways, try to explore yourself, your creativity, and once you are happy with the composition, with the design, you stop it and you'll realize that you are ready with a beautiful creation. Here I am adding OHP sheet to cover the frame so that the thermocol balls do not fall out, and using hot glue gun I will secure it nicely. And once that is done, I will again use the same stripes to cover and create a border around it. And thus our lovely wall frames are ready. All we have to do is use something to hang it. So for that I am using a jute thread and these buttons, which will be used to hold the thread. I am using hot glue gun to stick it together, and same I will do it for the other side as well. And the frame is ready to be hanged. Same way I will do it for the other frame as well, and at the end we will be hanging them all together. Now I am going to make a hanging wall shelf, and for this I am using this sweet box. This is quite strong, so it will hold the weight of few items that we will keep on top of it. So choose a good quality and a strong sweet box for this, creating holes on all the four edges. And to cover it, I will use these scrap papers that I already had. So it's a nice way to use your old scrap papers which are left over from other projects. So I'm using that. For the sides, I am using another designer paper. So this design was printed on the 12x12 sheet, and I just traced the design on it and cut it. And to make it a hanging shelf, I am using this jute thread. I am passing it through the hole that we had created earlier. Just slide in through the hole. Measure and see how long you want to keep the thread. So similarly, you pass it through another hole, and then tie a knot at the back. I am tying two knots so that it is tight and secure. Do it same on the another side as well, and you will have a wall hanging shelf ready. I am using cable clips to hang all the frames and hanging shelf onto the wall, but if you have nail or screws, you can use that also. So using hammer, I will drive the nail into the wall. So let's do that. See where you would like to place the frames. Just move here and there and finalize the place. I will suggest you not to use double-sided tape for sticking the frames on the wall, as it will make it fall frequently. You can use it for a lighter version of frames, like the one I have used in the previous video. So you can use for that kind of frames, but these frames are on a heavier side, so avoid using double-sided tape. And here a beautiful corner is ready. Just from few waste materials, we have created such a lovely place. So that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you do, then like, share and subscribe to my channel. Also, I will be posting next video on Wednesday, so stay tuned. In case you haven't turned on the notification button, please do that, subscribe to my channel, and yeah, I will see you guys soon in the next video. Till then, bye bye, happy crafting.